Good morning students. So welcome to online teaching class. This is Devi ma'am, your ABS teacher. So last week we have started our new chapter, Animals, Habitat and Adaptation. And today we will discuss about what do you mean by the term adaptation. So first I'm telling roughly. So what do you mean by the term adaptation? Adaptation means animals and human beings, how they are adjusting themselves into that particular habitat. For example, if we take the polar bear. So polar bear will live only in the polar region. So we can't able to live there, right? Why? Because the climate is very very cold. But the polar bear can able to live. Why? How? Because in their body some special adaptation will be there. So the adaptation help them to survive there. So what is the definition given here? An adaptation is a change in the physical feature or behavior of an organism to help to be better suited to this habitat. So which things will adapt themselves? So some of the animals, they use their body coverings. Some of the animals, they help the organs of movement. And some animals by means of the breathing organs. I am repeating again, listen. What do you mean by adaptation? So in a particular habitat, how the animals adapting themselves to survive. Either by using their body coverings or the organs of the movement or by using the breathing organs. So first, we will see adaptation in the body covering. So wool or fur. So mammals, mammals means the animals which give birth to their small ones. So mammals such as the bears, sheep and yak. So if you see these animals, they have the thick fur or wool on their body. Thick fur means what? The outermost coverage of their body. So these outermost covering, they keep themselves warm. This body covering, they keep their body warm. So by using this wool or fur, they are surviving in that habitat. Okay, then come to the scales. So what do you mean by the scale? So it is a flexible overlapping structure. Okay, so if we see some of the animals, their body parts, they are covered with these scales. For example, snake and lizard. If you see closely to these animals, the body part, they are covered with the scale. So what is the function of the scales? They prevent the water loss from their bodies. So if you see the snake and the lizard, they have the horny scales. If it is a crocodile, they have the thick plate scales. So every periodic season, the snake will shred their skin. Shred means what? Remove their skin. So the periodic shredding of old skin and it is replaced by the new one. It is called as a molting. I'm repeating again the scales. So some of the animals, they have the flexible overlapping structure. It is called as the scale. These scales, they prevent the water loss from their bodies. So if we take the snake and the lizard, they have the horny scales. If you see the crocodile, they have the thin plate-like scales. So every periodically, the snake will remove their old skin. So the periodic shredding of old skin and it is replaced by the new one, it is called as a molting. Then feathers and shell. So if you see the feathers, where the feathers will be? It is present on the birds, right? So birds, they have the feathers on their body. So why they have the feathers? Because it helps the birds to keep warm and also helps to fly. Okay, and what is the other function? Feathers keeps the body dry by preventing water from entering. So if we take the shells, shell example, tortoise, turtles and snail. They have their hard shell. So these shell, they protect their delicate bodies. Delicate means they have the very, very, very soft bodies. To protect their body, they have their shells here. And also to escape from the predators. Predators means it is an animal, their enemies. To protect their bodies from the enemies, they have the shells on their body. So first one, feather and shell. Birds have the feathers on their body to keep the birds warm, to fly, and also to prevent from water entering. These feathers are useful. And shell, some of the animals like tortoise, turtles and snails, they have their hard shells. Because they have the delicate body, soft bodies to protect themselves and from the animals, they have the shells. And then next one, how the organs, they help their adaptation. Adaptation in organs required for the movement. So what is the movement? Moving from one place to another. So for moving, which organs are useful to the animals? So first point, animals need to move from one place to another in search of food, water and shelter, right? So because plants are producers, they cannot move because the leaves will prepare their own food. But the animals, they need to move from one place to another to get the food, to drink the water and for shelter. And also to escape from the predators, they will move from one place to another. So for moving, which organs are helpful? So first one, limbs. Most terrestrial animals, means what? Animals which live on land. So if you see most terrestrial animals, they have the four limbs, right? They have the four legs. The front two limbs, they are called as the fore limbs, and the back two limbs, they are called as an hind limbs. We human beings, we also have the two upper limbs, that is the two hands and the two legs, right? By the means of the leg, we are moving. So how the frogs are moving? Frog, they will hop. Hop means well, they will jump from one place to another. So frogs hop around by using their strong and long hind limbs. If you see the frog, you can see the hind limbs will be very long. So by use of the hind limbs, they move from one place to another. Okay, as you all know, the frog is an amphibian, right? Amphibian means what? They live in water as well as in the land. So in the land, they use the hind limbs for movement. But in the water, they have the webbed feet, that is the back limbs, right? They have the webbed feet which help them to swim, right? And come to the birds. Birds also have the four limbs. They are modified into wings to fly, right? They also have the four limbs and the back limbs. The four limbs, it is modified into the wings to fly. So their body, they have this special hollow bones. So that make them lightweight and that help us to fly from one place to another. Then fins and flippers. That is the fish. They have the fins to move from one place to another in water. Some of the aquatic animals like dolphin and the whales, they will swim with the help of the flippers. If you see their body parts, they will have the flippers. By using the flippers, they will move from one place to another. I'm repeating again. So some of the organs, they help the animals for movement. Why the animals are moving? In search of the food, shelter and water and to escape from the predators. They are moving from one place to another. So limbs, what do you mean by the term limbs? Mostly all the terrestrial animals, they will have the four limbs, two hind limbs and the two fore limbs. So human beings, we also having the two legs and arms, two hands and the two legs for the movement. The frogs, they will hop from one place to another. Frog is an amphibian. It lives both in water and land. So in the land, it uses strong and long hind limbs. In the water, they use their webbed feet for swimming. Birds also have this one. Here, The four limbs are modified into wings. So the body is made up of the hollow bones which make them lightweight and help them to fly. So fish have the fins to swim in the water. Dolphin and the whales, they swim with the help of the flippers. And the next one, adaptation in the breathing organs. So how the breathing organs help them to adapt themselves. So first one, it is called as a spiracles. If you see the insect like grasshopper and the cockroaches, their body parts, they'll have the small holes. That small holes, they are called as a spiracles. So by the means of these spiracles, the air will enter, so the animals will breathe them. Okay, I'm repeating again, spiracles. If you take the small insect like grasshopper, cockroaches and housefly, their body, they will have the small tiny holes. These small tiny holes, they are called as spiracles, which help them to breathe. So by means of these spiracles, the air will go enters the insect. And then fish, as you all know, the fish breathe with the help of the gills. So when the fish breathes, it swallows the water through the mouth and passes it to the gills. So when the water passes over the gills, the oxygen dissolved in the water is absorbed by the blood vessels in the gills. So what they're telling, fish also breathe. They also take the oxygen which is present in the water. So when the fish breathes, what will happen? The water will enter into the mouth and then goes to the gills. When it reaches the gills, the blood vessels will be present in the gills. So the blood vessels will take that oxygen which is present in the water. By means of this way, the fish will breathe. Animals such as the reptiles, birds and the mammals, we breathe through the nose, right? So the air will move to the windpipe and enters the lungs, where the oxygen is absorbed into the bloodstream, as you all know. So we breathe with the help of the nose and it is swallowed, enter into the lungs. The lungs will take the oxygen and they will convert into the bloodstream. And then skin. So frog is an amphibian, right? As you all know. So frog and earthworms, they also use their moist skin to breathe. So when the frog is present on the land, it breathes through the lungs, and when it is present on the water, it will breathe through the moist skin. So these are all the adaptation. Today we have discussed about what we mean by the term adaptation. So adaptation in the body covering, adaptation in organs required for movement, and adaptation in the breathing organs. And tomorrow we will discuss about the special adaptations. Here are some of the IBL questions I have given. So listen this question carefully, write it in your fair notebook. So what is adaptation? How frogs respire? Which organs help fish to swim in water? Which animals breathe through their moist skin? So write these IBL questions in your fair notebook.